you?
Marty, is that you?
Hey, Doc, where are you?
Hank got a hold of you. Listen, Marty, can you meet me at 1:15 tonight from Hank's Mall? I've had a major breakthrough. I'll need your assistance.
Wait a minute. 1:15 in the morning?
Yeah.
What's going on? Where have you been all week?
Working. Remember now, it's 1:15 a.m. Twin Pines Mall.
Right.
Are those my clocks I hear?
Yeah, it's 8 o'clock.
They're late. My experiment worked. They're all exactly 25 minutes slow.
Wait a minute, Doc. Are you telling me it's 8:25?
Precisely.
Damn, I'm late for school.
Remember, George?
Yeah.
My name is Dr. Emmett Brown. I'm standing here on the parking lot of Twin Pines Mall. The time is 1:18 a.m. and this is temporal experiment number one. Come on, Einstein, hey boys.
Whoa. You got Einstein hooked up to this thing?
Please note that Einstein's clock is in complete synchronization with my control watch.
Great, check, Doc.
Good. Have Einstein.
Watch this.
Not me, the car. My calculations are correct. When this baby hits 88 miles per hour, you're going to see some serious stuff.
Oh yeah, 88 miles per hour.
Ha! What did I tell you? 88 miles per hour! The temporal displacement occurred at exactly 1:20 a.m. in 0 seconds.
Oh my god, Doc, you disintegrated Einstein.
Calm down, Marty, calm down. I didn't disintegrate anything. The molecular structure of both Einstein and the car are completely intact.
Then where the heck are they?
The appropriate question is, where the heck are they? Einstein has just become the world's first time traveler. He sends him into the future. 1 minute into the future, to be exact. And at exactly 1:21 a.m., we should catch up with him and the time machine.
Wait, Doc, are you telling me that you built a time machine out of Zillowing?
The way I see it, if you're going to build a time machine into a car, you might as well do it with some style. Besides, the stainless steel construction made the flux dispersal. Look out!
What? Is it hot?
It's cold. It's damn cold. Einstein, you little devil. Einstein's clock is exactly 1 minute behind mine. It's still ticking.
And he's fine.
Fine and completely unaware that anything ever happened. As far as he's concerned, the trip was instantaneous. Confused? Here, I'll show you how it works.
Right. Bob.
Oh, hey, Biff. How you doing?
Yeah. Got my homework finished?
Well, I figured it wasn't due till Monday. So.
Hello. And anybody home, McFly? Think, McFly, think. I gotta have time to recopy it. You realize what happens if I hand in my homework in your handwriting? I'll get kicked out of school, and you wouldn't want that to happen, would you?
Would you? No, of course not. Tell you what, I'll get those finished up first thing tomorrow morning.
Okay, McFly, shoes untied.
Ha ha ha!
This is with the life preserver. Hey, what you looking at, kid? I don't want to see you in here again.
You're George McFly.
Yes, and you are?
Hey, why do you want to push your mom like that?
Well, I mean, he's bigger than you.
Dad, wait, I mean, George, wait!
Truth, Doc, you gotta believe me.
So tell me,
and you fell and you hit your head on the city. And that's when he came up with the flux capacitor, which makes time travel possible. I've been poking my toilet. I drew this. Flux capacitor.
It works! It works! I finally invented something that works!
You bet it works.
We gotta take the time machine back to my laboratory. We gotta get you home!
Right, all we need is a nuclear reaction of 1.21 gigawatts.
Wait, what did you just say?
1.21 gigawatts.
What?
Plutonium.
I'm sure that in 1985, plutonium was available in every corner drugstore. But 1955, it's a little hard to come by, Marty. I'm afraid you're stuck here.
Whoa, stuck here, Doc? I can't be stuck here. I have a life in 1985.
I'm sorry, Marty, but the only power source capable of generating 1.21 gigawatts is a bolt of lightning.
What did you say?
A bolt of lightning. Unfortunately, you never know when or where it's ever going to strike.
We do now.
This is it! This is it! It says here that at precisely 10:04 p.m. next Saturday night, a bolt of lightning will hit the clock tower. Next Saturday night, we're sending you back to the future!
Okay, Saturday's good. I could spend the week in 1955. I could hang out. You could show me around.
Marty, that's completely out of the question. You must not leave this house. You must not see anybody. You must not talk to anybody. Anything you do could have serious repercussions on future events. Do you understand?
Yeah, sure. Okay.
Martin, have you interacted with anybody since you got here besides myself?
Yeah, well, like, kinda ran into my parents.
Let me see. Do you have a photograph of you from the future?
Here, me and my siblings.
Just as I thought. This proves my theory. Look at your brother.
His head is gone. It's like it's been erased.
Erased from existence.
This sounds pretty heavy.
Well, it has nothing to do with it.
Wait, so you mean if my parents don't meet, they won't fall in love? And if they don't fall in love, I won't exist?
Precisely, you and your sister will follow unless you repair the damages.
What are you doing? George?
Rain is down.
All right, get over. My density is probably 2 years.
What?
What I meant to say was...
Hey, don't I know you're from somewhere?
Yes, I'm George. George McFly, and I'm your density. I'm your destiny.
Oh.
Hey, McFly, I thought I told you to scram. What's gonna cost? How much money you got?
Well, then...
All right, come now.
I'm gonna be really sad.
that I'm gonna succeed in this, that I'm gonna have the chance to travel through time. It's gonna be really hard waiting 30 years to talk to you again, Marty. I'm really gonna miss you.
I'm really gonna miss you too, Doc, about the future.
No, Marty! We're ready to discuss how your information about the future could be extremely dangerous.
Thank you.
Marty, will we ever see you again?
I guarantee it.
Marty, I want to thank you for all your good advice. I'll never forget it.
Right, George. Well, good luck, you guys. Oh, right. And if you guys ever have kids, and one of them, when he's 8 years old, says fair to living in the world, be easy on him.
Marty, such a nice name.
Thank you.
come too. Just be careful, and if you have a student who's in the production, they can stay in their costume for a photo. If you want them to, just make sure that they leave all costume items that belong to us behind. Again, thank you for coming. We really appreciate it, and have a lovely night.